All right, so this is going to be Capricorn Sun, Capricorn Moon, and as well Capricorn Rising. Weekly general tarot reading April 13th to April 19th, 2020. And in case any of you guys is interested into a personal reading with me, checking out the description down below is going to give you a link to my website from which you can purchase such. And as well, if you want to start reading tarot cards, if you don't know how, and you like the way I do it, I'm offering a online live tarot classes in which, for starters, I'm going to explain you all the major arcana, how to read them in terms of career, in terms of relationship, in a positive, in a negative way, into the dedicated spread I chose and that I use primarily for my private readings. So at the end of the course, you are set to go to make your own readings or to open your own business, hopefully. So that being said, moving to the first card, which represents the topic of your week, that is to be Capricorn, that is to be the Ten of Wands, followed by the energies which are feeding and supporting the topic here. That is going to be the Emperor card, so very promising start. It is what we do have here. Followed by the challenges that you have to face, and that's a big one. We do have the challenge of the Fool. Furthermore, is going to be the gifts and the blessings that you get to enjoy throughout the week. That is going to be the Nine of Swords. Afterwards, it is the impression that you are leaving into the people around, the impression of the Seven of Pentacles, and the last one, which stands as the guidance the Tower is offering, that will be the guidance of the Hierophant. Okay, so it's a promising week because the Emperor, along with the Ten of Wands, there is only one sentence that can cumulatively explain both cards as they sit into energy and into topic, and that is that you are going to structure appropriately your week in a sense of that at the end you have a not exactly only full control over everything, but also you dealt with all the ups and downs that could have been there. Okay? So it's like a new world order or new code of conduct into your romantic life, into your career life as well, or into your environment also, which is fully in sync and adapted to the global situation, which right now is quarantine. Well, not global situation, but your global situation, whichever that situation is. So the way I see it, it is that instead of being mesmerized and how can I say it, being dragged and enthralled by things you don't have, you are gonna make the most out of the things you do have. So you can expect to really storm your business or your career and make great things with it. You can expect to storm your marriage as well, or your relationship, or your romantic life, if you will, and make great things out of it as well. Now, it's going to be very busy times because with the Ten of Wands, which is the situation, many things are going to, I would say, move around. I don't want to say happening, but move around in the sense of that will demand attention. Because we can see that into the last card as well, but here with the Ten of Wands, because everything it requires its incorporation in a sense of that you cannot neglect aspects. Okay, you can't neglect aspects into your marriage. You can't neglect aspects into your career as well. But identifying that all of the aspects there or all of the details there can and should and needs to be attended, and you have the right formula how to attend them. At the end, you create one whole which identifies your domain or defines your domain, in which domain you rule your empire. So it's all about that, that instead of allowing the life to rule you up until now, you are going to start ruling over your life. Now, however, the energies of the Emperor, they bring big responsibilities. I mean, because the Emperor sits on a throne, the throne is a symbol of responsibilities in tarot, and nothing is bigger than the Emperor's throne. Therefore, you have to understand that at sometimes you can't make a decision that is going to be loved by everybody. That is, an example of it could be given by a child that needs to be vaccinated, you know, with the syringe and needle, right? The child doesn't want to, but it does not understand that that is a for his own good, and you have to pretty much enforce your will over the child. So that is what the emperor does. It enforces its will because not everybody sees the things the way the emperor sees them, and the emperor does things for the greater good or for the stability of the domain rather than for the goodness, for the wellness of the people. This is what I explained in my class as well. That is the difference in between the empress and the emperor. The empress is going to go by with the child wishes, and it's not going to go to vaccinate it, while the emperor wouldn't care about the child's wishes, only cares about, you know, how his domain is going to be sustained. So that kind of a how can I say it, behavior, it is what those energies are going to push you into throughout this week. So for some people you may look very ruthless, almost cold-hearted, but that's not the case. You just want to you will just want and also will be able to establish your things and make them very reliable, rock solid, and with a very well defined structure that can be counted on. And out of that, like I said, amazing things are going to come out. Okay, that is the promise of the Ten of Wands, but you should not lose your grip over your career, your marriage, or your life overall. I mean, you should not allow it to let it go, and whatever happens, happens. You gotta aim to maintain a full control, and you gotta hold the rule of your ship constantly throughout this week, which you will definitely gonna be able to, looking at those couple of cards. So moving next, it is the challenge here, and that will be the challenge of the full card. So obviously a lot will hang on your shoulders. How can you have a fun, right? Well, with the challenge of the Fool, it comes to not the idea, but the vision, mostly the vision. You know, what is the greater good out of it? You know, right now you are having you are going to have your life throughout the week rather solid, structured, which predispose that there isn't going to be much fun in it. So at the end of the day, you may ask yourself why I'm doing that if I'm not experiencing any exhilaration through it. Well, that is the challenge of the Fool, that you got to focus on your end goal. You know, how you're going to get there right now, it's not really matter. What matters is the result of your efforts, or rather like the results that you are going to achieve based on the means and the resources you do have right now. And the means are, and resources as the ability to control everything that is happening around you. So the Fool, we have explained in the classes why it comes with number zero, but basically the Fool promises you everything that is objectively achievable, and you can do it through maintaining, once again, a control. So no slacking, no postponing responsibilities from your behalf. That is also included with the Emperor. You got to do the things the way they need to be done, and also they are supposed to be done, which we're going to see here into the last card. And therefore, especially if you do have family with the Fool card, it will be a bit difficult for you to enjoy a bit time with your family, or to enjoy the time spent with your family, because you are going to have a lot of things on your head once again, and on your shoulders, a lot of things to take care of. The next one, which stands as the gifts and the blessings. Oh, one more thing about the Fool card, I forgot about it. It is that you have to take it. Now, it will be difficult to accept, you know, all those responsibilities that are going to fall on your shoulders as a muse of your life. You are most likely, at least in its initial state, you're going to accept it as obligations, the very annoying obligations that you need to deal with. But if you try to adopt a different perspective, you will see that they can be actually very pleasant to be performed, and you definitely can take them as a muse. If I have to give myself as an example, making those videos, I could look at them as a chore that I have to do, all right? Or I can look at them as a training that I am doing, you know, a practice that I'm doing, which I'm doing every day with my tarot cards. But it's just an additional practice for me. And instead of, for example, looking them as an annoying thing, I should be kind of like looking forward to see what kind of a message the card has, like a story-wise, you know, storytelling. And it's like reading a book rather than making an annoying readings, which I'm getting there. You know, it's easier and easier because right now it's quite interesting to see what every sign is going through. So going forward, we do have the gifts and the blessings that you are to enjoy here. That is to be the gift and the blessing of the Nine of Swords. That is the gifts of understanding the true impact of your action and also being able to overcome with a severe ease, not exactly disappointments, but the or being humble regarding how the things are. So one thing needs to be done and it just needs to be done, all right? And you do not feel regret, pity, nor a poignancy that you have to do it despite of how it's going to be taken from the rest. Like said, from the child with the vaccination, all right? The child is going to cry, it's going to be in pain for a little while, but it's important to be done because it's for his greater good. So you're not going to have any remorse of doing those stuff. That will be your blessing here, understanding that at the end of the day, the impact of your actions is going to be an impact of growth upon your life. So we can say that you are going to be blessed with unnecessary ruthlessness, okay? Moving next, it is the impression of the people around. That will be the Nine of Pentacles. So people, that is a baffling impression because people will see you, it is like you are slowing down the pace. That is because they do not see everything that is happening into your life. And like we said, you are going to start maintaining control over your life and not control over the exterior, right? So people are not going to see you very active outside of your domain, which means your family or your career as well. And that will be very baffling for them. They will think that you are preparing something. They will think that you are waiting for something to happen. And then, you know, it's like making your big shot. And that is very important for the energy of the Emperor. Now, you need to remember with the Emperor that dignity does not dictate the whole truth to be told. As a matter of fact, the little people know about you, the better, because the Emperor always has its enemies, okay? And you don't want to accumulate such people that are becoming enemy of yours because they envy how well you are tackling with your life and how well your life is developing throughout this week. And the final card for you, Capricorn, it is referring to the guidance, that is the Hierophant. And like we said, the Hierophant, it is very linked, very well linked with the Emperor here and the Ten of Wands. And the Hierophant points that when you want something, there is already established way how you are going to do it. And that way needs to be honored and needs to be manifested in generally, okay? My assistant once told me, you know, when you start dating with a girl, you can't go straight away for the orgasm, okay? First, you need to kind of go out, date, kiss, have your romantic dinners, the love play as well, the love game, and etc. And then the sex, and after that is the orgasm. You can't go for it straight away. So this is what the Hierophant preaches here, that there are necessary things that needs to be accomplished. You very well will know which those things are. It could be annoying at the start. It could be a bit aggravating as well, but you can definitely change that perspective. Have no remorse that you have to do them despite how others are going to see into it. And at the end, become the Emperor of your life. So that was your weekly tarot reading, Capricorn. Hopefully you enjoyed it and you liked it. And once again, if you're interested in a private reading with me, you can check out the description down below. There you're going to find a link to my website from which you can purchase such. And if you are interested into learning tarot cards and you like the way I read the cards, I'm offering an online live tarot classes in which I'm going to explain you for the starter course, all the major arcana, how to read them in terms of career, relationship, positive and negative way as well, and how they sit in generally in every single position into the spread that I'm using primarily into my business, because I'm using it for the class and using it as well for my private reading, because it's a brilliant spread. And at the end of the class, you will learn how to read in general, you know, because the spread can be used as well only for major arcana. And so hopefully you will start doing your own readings. So that being said, stay safe now and see you next time. Until then, bye.